Welcome to RMIT Vietnam, where inspiration is everywhere. This is a place where lecturers inspire students, and students inspire each other to advance themselves in their own unique way. We are an Australian university in the heart of vibrant Ho Chi Minh City. This is where business, technology, and design comes alive through creative and innovative ideas. RMIT Vietnam is not just a place where you go to study. It's where you find and realise your passion. Immerse yourself in a world-class environment. Learn real-world skills. Live with passion. Play hard. And love who you are. University is going to be a big part of your life, so make the most out of it. We give you the tools to form yourself. Find the real you at RMIT.
Hello and welcome to RMIT Vietnam Orientation Week. My name is Professor Rick Bennett. I'm the Executive Dean for Academic and Students, and it's my privilege and honour to welcome you all, so many new faces, to RMIT Vietnam. Whether you're in Ho Chi Minh City, whether you're in Hanoi, or whether you're in Da Nang, it's my pleasure to welcome you in this new chapter in your life and become part of our extended family of students here at RMIT. So welcome to you all. And to be honest, of course, university can be challenging. So many projects, so many assessments, and they're all coming one after the other. But good news, don't worry, there's so many people here to help you. Professional staff, academic staff. So make sure you create your own networks of support, and don't be shy to use those networks. At RMIT University, we're inspired by our core values, which is to provide a transformative learning experience for all our students and ultimately to get them ready for life and work. So whether you're an international student or a local Vietnamese student, you'll receive the highest quality Australian education, one that is recognised by employees worldwide. And great things start with great dreams, and great dreams start with imagination. And imagination is the first of RMIT's core values. So don't forget, everybody, be imaginative. Now, passion is a great part of what makes our community so exciting. And passion is one of our RMIT values also. But for our community to thrive, passion must walk hand in hand with compassion and inclusion. And again, inclusion is another one of our RMIT values. And at RMIT, we also really value courage. So don't be afraid to speak up. But if you do speak up, always do so with mutual respect for the people or the person you're talking to. And be really informed by facts. Perhaps don't be informed by biased information or something you might just read on social media. Now, while you're a student here at RMIT University, we really hope that you make an impact. Impact is one of our important university values. And to make an impact, often it means you have to be agile, another one of our values. And agility means adapting to situations that arise that perhaps are maybe unexpected. And a fantastic example of that was the past year where our students and our staff have been agile in addressing the challenges that have been raised by the COVID-19 virus. So what's next? Well, let me hand you over to Alison, who's our Director of Student Experience and Success, and see what she's got planned to broaden your whole student experience.
Thank you, Rick, for the warm introduction. And a big congratulations to all of you. As an RMIT student, you are about to embark on a journey of a lifetime. You will have an experience like no other, and rest assured, we'll be here to guide you all along the way. You will have access to state-of-the-art facilities and the many student services available to you should you require extra support. For instance, you can reach out to RMIT Student Connect whenever you have questions or need advice throughout your university life. RMIT Student Connect is here to help you with all of your enrollment questions, and they can refer you to other student service areas as well. We also have Student Academic Success, offering a range of learning services for all RMIT students, including expert writing and language support, as well as our popular program tutors, who are here to help you with all of your courses and assignments. RMIT's fantastic librarians are ready to help you source materials and conduct research for your programs. And you can even chat with a librarian remotely whenever you need quick help online. And remember, university life is not just about studying. Your personal development is central to RMIT's philosophy. RMIT's Career Services team is here to help you achieve all of your professional goals, from internships to mentoring, volunteering to networking. We're here to help you shape your future. Feeling excited, but not sure if you might become overwhelmed? At RMIT, we understand the importance of a healthy study-life balance. Every student is unique, and every situation is unique. The well-being team cares about your physical, social, and emotional well-being, and is here to make sure you can succeed to the best of your ability and enjoy yourself at the same time. So are you ready, but not sure where to start? The Orientation Day and How-To RMIT programs will provide you with everything you need to know to feel confident as a new student.
Greetings! Welcome to RMIT Vietnam Livestream Orientations. I'm Mai, I'll be the MC for today. Allow me to first extend my congratulations to you all for being a bigger part of RMIT Vietnam community. Even though we cannot meet on the campus today, rest assured, we'll bring you all the helpful and exciting information for you to begin your journey with us. Before we come to the main parts, let's shake things up a little bit with some students' performances. Let's go! Hopping on a red eye. Hopping on a red eye. I can rest assured that when you're on the other end of it, looking forward to the descent and you're out. See you when I touch down. You're my champagne, you made me pop off everywhere like confetti. Yeah. I know it seems strange, I seen you last night and I miss you already. Yeah. My bed is depressed, my pillow's a victim. Chills, but my hands are sweaty. And I had to fly out. Bet you got me strung out. Hopping on a red eye. Thank you, our lovely students, for such next-level performances. Now coming up next is the warm welcome speech from Mr. Philip Dowler, head of Hanoi Campus.
Welcome to RMIT Hanoi City Campus. As a new student, you're about to embark on a wonderful journey of discovery. The RMIT Hanoi City Campus is right in the heart of the vibrant city of Hanoi. It's a city and campus of endless possibilities. It's a great place to make a lot of connections, have wonderful coffee, enjoy and meet your friends. So studying is all about getting out of your comfort zone. Your life as an RMIT student is more than just academic achievement, more than books, reading, and lectures. It's about getting out there and embracing the thrill and joy of being an RMIT student. So I encourage you to get out there, take the wonderful opportunity of joining student club activities, fun tours around the campus. Get out there and embrace your life as an RMIT student. It's your time to shine.
And today, I'm gonna be your tour guide for your RMIT Hanoi campus virtual tour. While the front of Hanlira School building faces a vibrant and bustling street, the back of it faces Ngoc Hang Lek, a place where our students and lecturers wind down and mingle with nature after a hard day of work and study. Let me take a sip of my white coffee that I just bought from a coffee shop nearby our school. Wow, it still tastes amazing as always. Now, let's follow me and explore this campus. Walking into Tower B, on the left-hand side, you will see RMIT reception area, the first area you will enter at RMIT. This is where prospective students and parents get information from our consultants or be directed to relevant departments. Next to SOS office is Student Connect. This is where I provide you simple ways to access student service and support. Here, we can help you with different types of inquiries, university policies and procedures, as well as help you to improve your learning outcome. You will drop by this room quite a lot during your time here at RMIT. Moving down the hallway, on the right-hand side is the International SOS office. Here, we have a team of professional doctors and nurses trained in Vietnam and abroad. You can choose to make an appointment with your desired doctor or visit without any appointment. All are private and confidential. Do you know that truly global experience is one of the reasons why newbies choose RMIT? It includes going on a short course overseas, going on exchange to RMIT Melbourne, or over 200 partner universities around the world. If you're feeling stressed and a little down, you can visit RMIT Wellbeing and Counseling Office. Here, you will receive one-on-one counseling with our experienced counselors who will listen to your concerns without any judgment. At RMIT, your mental well-being is highly paid attention to and appreciated. The RMIT Vietnam Library offers over 80,000 books in English with a 24/7 access to 300 databases like ebooks, journals, and reports from well-known publishers all around the world. As an RMIT Hanyu student, you can cross-loan books from San Jose campus or Melbourne-based campuses. I did this with Michelle Obama Books, and it was such an amazing experience. Student Academic Success offers a range of academic support services. Some popular services are learning and language advising, peer-assisted learning services, and SAS Learning Lab. You can drop by as a one-on-one, or you can come here with a small group to review your course content or practice assignments with our peer tutor that come right from your program. RMIT students are entitled to different types of computer labs. On level 2, we enter PC Lab 1 and Mac Lab. While the PC Lab can accommodate general computer needs of our students, Mac Lab can serve more heavy-duty tasks since they have the most advanced graphic cards, so that we can do tasks like graphic designs, video editing, or movie rendering here. Classrooms at RMIT are mostly located on level 4, 5, 6, and 7, are equipped with cutting-edge equipment like PCs, projectors, multimedia software, and audio system to help our students get the most out of the study. There's one fun fact that our classroom can be merged together to make a bigger space if needed. One outstanding room that all students need to know is club room. Here, our club gather and have fun together. If you're lucky, you can even enjoy a random live show from music club or a ping pong match from our students. Let's go! Go! On level 5, you will come across a TV signage which announces all sport events and activities in fitness and recreation room. The room provides a range of world-class sport, fitness, and recreation facilities, helps promote social connectivity, teamwork, and skill development. You can join our yoga workshops or other activities, as well as use our personal trainer service. Now, let me try lifting this dumbbell. It's not my kind of sport. Actually, My favorite activities to do in Rec Room is dancing. Level 8 is the most popular area in RMIT. Here, we have student breakout room. The room is equipped with TV screen, microwaves, refrigerator, and more. Let me tell you a secret. You can play PS games with our TV screen, and it's totally legal. Here is our student council room, a group of students who represent RMIT's student body, in charge of protect student rights, provide full support, and enhance student experience here at RMIT. Every year, they will run a campaign for their desired position as an officers or executives. This is where RMIT Student Life is located. As is shown in the name, RMIT Student Life offers a range of activities, events, clubs, and projects to maximize students' experience at RMIT. Believe me, you will love to join the engaging activities in a journey tier, and they are totally free. The Level 9 receptions welcome students when they make an appointment with the lecturers to consult or get feedbacks on their assignments. Thank you for joining me today. There are so many more interesting things that I cannot show in one video, so I will leave them for you to explore yourself. I wish you have an unforgettable time at RMIT. At RMIT, there are several student services available to support you, but how to start using those? Let's meet RMIT Student Connect representative, and she will guide you through how to utilize. You can find RMIT Student Connect to find answer for all your pressing concerns and issues here at RMIT.
Hello and welcome to RMIT University. As a new student, we understand that you might have a lot of questions. We are here to support you from the beginning of your RMIT journey to the moment you finish your degree. Where do you start finding answers for your questions? Things like how to enroll in the courses, how to get your student card, when and how to pay your tuition fees, which courses and programs are suitable for you, how to get help to find a job, or even how to balance between your study and personal life. Think of RMIT Student Connect as your simple way to access student services. We help you to connect to the available supports for your student admin essentials and personal needs. You can connect with us via the online portal anywhere, anytime, on any device, or just give us a call. The RMIT Connect online portal is the quick and simple way for you to submit an inquiry or book an appointment with Student Connect or other services. Thank you. need to find us, we locate in Building 1 at the Saigon South Campus or on Level 1 Hanoi Campus. So, for all your RMIT student admin and support, please visit our website here.
Thank you, RMIT Student Connect, for a very detailed presentation. I'm sure that many students have found that really useful, and RMIT Student Connect office will be filled with students in the next few weeks. Now, moving up next, let me introduce to you the biggest student organization here at RMIT, RMIT Student Council, the representative of RMIT Vietnam student bodies.
Hello, new students, and welcome. You are now a part of the larger student community at RMIT Vietnam University and the wider RMIT global community. I am the Vice President of Student Council Generation 10 at Saigon South Campus. The RMIT Vietnam Student Council is the representative for RMIT Vietnam student bodies. It is the conduit for communications between the students and the university. By listening and considering students' concerns, Student Council aims to enhance educational experience, enrich your social life and cultural activities. We work passionately every day to serve, support, and make sure your student life at RMIT Vietnam is always fun and meaningful experience. The Student Council organizes into 7 executive positions, overseeing 14 offices across Hanoi and Saigon South Campus, with 8 offices in Saigon South Campus, 6 offices in Hanoi Campus, and subcommittee members who are recruited to support the running of the offices. They are all students with great passions, energy, and highly motivated like yourself, who aspires toward a common goal to make RMIT a diverse, inclusive, and rewarding playground for everyone. As an RMIT student, you are invited to participate in all activities and events run and organized by Student Council. It is your benefit after all. Some of our signature events are Relax and Recharge, Student Staff Consultative Committee meetings, which also involves your participation to give feedback about the courses to the schools so that we can make appropriate adjustments to enhance your academic success and learning experience. And last but not least is Club Day, the most awaited day of the whole semester for all students. At Club Day, you get to meet up, interact face-to-face, and find out as much as you can about RMIT clubs and societies. Executives and officers of Student Council are the current RMIT Vietnam students that are elected for a 1-year term by all RMIT Vietnam student bodies through a transparent, democratic, and annual election campaign. They are voted and selected by students to work towards a better community for students. Cannot wait a whole year to be a part of Student Council? Join Student Council as subcommittee or event volunteer. The recruitment information is always posted on our official Facebook fan page. Be sure to check it often.
Every new semester at RMIT, our newbies have so many questions for us about how student life at RMIT looks like. So today, I'm very excited to be here with our 3 special guests, our 3 outstanding students and club leaders at RMIT Hanoi Campus. We will hear about their journey and experience at RMIT and hope that this word will inspire you and help you to have a smooth transition into a university life. I'm Ban Mai, and I'll be the host for today. Let's get to know about each other a bit, shall we? Can we start with Cuong first?
Thank you, Mai. Hello, everyone. I'm Du Cuong. I am a transfer student, and I'm in my final year, majoring in economics and finance. I'm currently working as a president of RMIT Business Club in Hanoi. It's my honor to be here sharing with all of you about my university experience, and I hope this will give new students a little more confidence and preparation for the college years ahead.
So how about me?
Warm greetings to everyone, especially our beloved newbies who are watching this orientation day. My name is Dan Chami and I'm a second year professional communication student at RMIT. I'm currently working as the Vice President of RMIT Vietnam Student Council, Generation 10, and it's my honor to be here with all of you today. And if you ever see me at the Hanoi campus, please don't hesitate to say hello and maybe we could be friends after that.
Okay,
So hello everyone, my name is Lao Chen and I'm majoring in economics and finance. Also, this is my final year at RMIT.
Thank you so much for your nice introduction. It's so great to have all of you here today. So I think we can start with the first questions. From your personal experience, what is the biggest differences between high school and university?
Okay, so from my perspective, the biggest difference is that there is no limit of how many club activities that you should join but still be able to maintain a good academic result. I think that to do that, we must become a town master. And it might sound a bit unclear, right? But put differently, I think that we must have a efficient timetable. And you can do that by have a time journal to list out every task that you need to do in the next day. So when you wake up, you would know what to do given specific time ranges. Oh, and there's one more thing that you need to know in order to perform all of that, you must have a good health. So start taking care of yourself now by sleeping early and focusing on what you do best.
Yes, totally agree. Actually, from my personal experience, I only joined one club during my university life because I want to get to know them as much as I could. And I could also pay all of my attention to one place. However, I'm making the most out of it. So I think it's also a good decision, right? So what about Anh Cường? I know that you had a lot of student experience during your time in Australia. So what is the biggest difference between high school and university from your point of view?
I used to work as president of Vietnamese Student Association in Wollongong City in Australia. With that role, I was loved and supported by super amazingly talented individuals. I was taught new things, I was brought to new places. So the difference between high school and university is whether you'll be able to network with others. In high school, your main focus is study and pass the university entrance exam. But 3 years at college are not merely for academic purposes, but also for the great experiences that only come when you have a strong network. For me, as an RMIT student now, networking is good in two ways. Number one, I could find good teammates for the assignments and find new ideas for my business club projects when I network with other fellow students. Number two, I can gain more career advice and internship opportunities when I network with professionals and experts.
Yes, I couldn't agree more. Networking is super important, especially when it comes to university. One more key difference between high school and university that I want to add on is the presence of student bodies that represent student voice, called Student Council. So me, as a vice president of Student Council, can you tell us about its missions and how the council works?
Yes, Mai. So at RMIT, we have Student Council, which is a for student and by student department. We are always here to support, advocate, and represent the student at RMIT 100 campus. And as Student Council members, we have the chance to work and collaborate with various department and professional staff at RMIT, such as our brothers and sisters at Student Life, Careers, Marketing, and many other RMIT departments. And moreover, being the Vice President of Student Council at Hanoi Campus, I'm the Student Council representative to work with Student Council in Saigon South and other RMIT leaders.
Wow. I think that study and academic results is also a very common topics among our newbies, right? So what are your learning or studying strategies or approaches to get PhDs and academically success as a RMIT student? Would you mind sharing your tips with our newbies?
New students may be swamped by a lot of new things at RMIT, especially the learning process. Mm-hmm. However, you just need to make sure that you can fully understand the lectures. If not, book a consultation with your professors because they will definitely have you to sort things out. Or you can visit the SAS, Student Academic Success, the name tells us everything, right? Professional academic learning advisor help you to, you know, study, design a study plan, especially support with English, academic writing, mathematics and statistics. They also have the peer assisted learning services where you can get support from high performing students.
So it sounds really great, and you know, we love those services like a lot as students, right? So with such differences and changes from high school to university, what challenge you all of you the most as the newbies, and how you what do you do to overcome those challenges?
College is absolutely different from high school. We talk a lot about this, right? In my first year, I met hundreds of students, if not thousands, who were at my age or older than me. They have different backgrounds. They came from different corners of the world. There are so many outstanding achievements. At that time, my problem was that I just kept comparing myself to others and becoming stressful and discouraged because I just tried to live up with other expectations, and that's just had no ending. It was then I learned to accept myself, accept my flaws. I focus time on my life, not the lives of others. I try to not envy the achievements and blessing of other people. Instead, be happy for them and just keep carry on with my life.
So in my case, it's peer pressure. So before in this position, I was just like newbies right now, a freshman who just graduated from high school, and choosing RMIT was a turning point in my life. I was used to being overwhelmed with college life and went through peer pressure since there was lots of talented and hardworking people out there. But after all, I realized that focusing on other successes only burdens myself. And it is better to focus on yourself and what you have done. For example, you can think about things that you would like to do or what would you like to be in the future. Having the answer to this question, I think you will find your own way to conquer university life.
Okay, so there is one thing you guys might want to know about me is that I have always been an introvert, and I don't deny that even when I went to university, I'm still an introvert and I don't change who I am right now. But instead of doing things without any happiness and joy, I try so hard to welcome any chances that will come to me at RMIT. And I learned one amazing fact that whenever I welcome chances, they would always bring me back so many beautiful benefits which I have never thought of, like amazing friends and unforgettable memories and experiences. So my advice is that all you have to do is just applying the position that you like and try your best, just like what I have did when I'm joined the Red Team, which is a volunteer program held by the Student Life Department that helps students to involved in school activities to gain more experiences and cultivate their skill sets. Or you can join the club activities because there's friends and they will help you to define who you are at university. And regarding my part-time job as Student Connect Concierge, I feel like RMIT's part-time jobs will help me devotedly to understand what it looks like when we graduate and have a full-time job outside. So surely, RMIT always opens and prioritizes job chances for RMIT students. So be ready to catch your chances. Yeah, and of course, at RMIT, you don't have to change who you are. Just be yourself and shine in your own way.
Thank you for sharing those ideas. I think a lot of newbies can relate to your insightful stories, like how to be involved in the new environment even when you're an introvert, or how to overcome peer pressure. So Chen's advice for our newbies is just to be yourself and embrace your personality and true color. Why Kung's and me tips is to focus on yourself and do what you do best. And that's the time when you can shine and make the most out of everything. So from the beginning of this session, I heard that the quickest way to become part of RMIT is to join clubs, student council, or volunteer programs. So I guess our newbies are really curious about the process of how to join clubs or apply for student council or RED volunteer programs. So can you three briefly talk about the process, please?
Let me talk about the club recruitment first, because Business Club is my pride. So at the beginning of every semester, all clubs will be looking for new members, like a new wind of change. You can find out more about detailed information on about each club, such as its mission, its visions, how to contact, how to apply on Student Life Handle Facebook page or each club Facebook page. With the recruitment of student council, I may have to ask the critical next to me.
About student council, Subcommittees are selected via recruitment announced on RMIT Vietnam Student Council Facebook page, which is usually reoccur once per year in semester 3. And moreover, if you want to become a core team member of Student Council, such as executives or officer, you have to go through a transparent and democratic election process, which is usually happen in semester 1, often in April.
So just like what Kung and Mi has said, you can always check your Outlook email and visit the Student Life Facebook page for the latest announcements regarding the recruitment. And if you look for any job vacancies, not only at RMIT, but also in other corporations, you can always visit the Career Hub all the time and whenever you need.
One of the biggest changes from high school to university is we're starting to use email like a lot, right? Yeah, so newbies, don't forget to check your mailbox frequently as well as follow RMIT Student Life Hanoi Facebook page to stay updated with latest news. It's almost the end of our discussions, so I would love each of our guests to say something to our newbies, maybe share tips or an advice to help them feel more ready to start their journey here at RMIT. Can we start with Chen?
Okay, so now you can see that my story is just that simple. Even you can do it and do it even better. So all you have to do is just to put more effort into what you do best, confront challenges with a kind heart and bravery, and open your heart more to every possibility and opportunities. Just embracing your personality and be patient, because everyone has his or her own pace and slowly you will get there. So just slow down and enjoy your youth at RMIT. Surely RMIT will not let you down. It will bring you so much laugh and memories too. So how about Iko?
Lovable, nice, respectful, understanding, talented, energetic. That is how I would describe the amazing business club members and other RMIT students in general that I'm so fortunate to have them as my friends. Ask people their goals and life in work and don't hesitate to share with them yours. And try to see how you guys can give support to one another. Just wholeheartedly build your relationships simply with a smile, growing with talking and hanging around.
So recently there's an Italian phrase that I really like, which is ancora imparo, means I'm still learning. I know that it is not easy to acknowledge your values or stop comparing yourself to others, but I think it is better to focus on self-development because I believe that at the end of the day, we have already made progress. Maybe it can vary due to different people, but just give yourself praise after each day, because living is learning and it is a lifelong journey. So just enjoy it to the fullest and keep shining as the way you are.
We're coming to the end of senior student panel discussion today. I would like to send my sincerest thanks to three special guests today. Your thoughts and stories are really lovely to be here and talk about. We also wish our newbies all the best and hope that you can make the most out of your journey here, even more than we did. At RMIT, it's your time to shine. University life isn't just about studying, right? Here at RMIT Hanoi campus, we have 11 clubs and societies, ranging from sport, arts, academics, social interests, you can name it. Let's have a look. Introduction clip has brought us to the end of our orientation today. Thank you so much for being with us. Don't forget to check your RMIT mailbox, website, and also the Newbie Hubs for all the helpful information. All the links will be in the description box down below. Now, once again, our live stream will be recorded and remain on the YouTube channel for you to come back anytime that you need. Thank you for being with us, and I'll see you all around. Goodbye!